Hello students, hope you are fit and fine and faring well in online studies. Today we are here with a new chapter from your textbook First Flight, The 100 Races Part 1. The name of the chapter is The 100 Races Part 1, written by E.L. Sir Ister. Please be prepared to listen attentively. Here we have the introduction first of all. The lesson, The 100 Races, first is about a girl named Wanda who claims to have 100 races. Her classmates made fun of her because what she claims is in contradiction to the fact that she was always seen wearing the same dress. Her classmates found her name to be funny. It was because everyone had easier names than Wanda Petronsky. Her name was different because she was a Polish immigrant. Polish immigrant that refers to people from Poland. So she was a Polish immigrant who had come to an American town with her family. She was poor and did not have many friends. She was quiet and was always seen sitting in the corner of the classroom. The truth about the 100 races unveiled when she submitted her 100 drawings in a drawing contest. They were the same 100 races she used to talk about. All of them were immensely beautiful. Now let's go for the summary of the story. The story is about a quiet and shy girl named Wanda Petronsky, a Polish immigrant, that is, someone from Poland happened to a town in USA. So she was a Polish immigrant who had come to America with her family. She attended a school with American children who found her name to be a strange and probably the weirdest in the classroom. That is, strangest in the classroom. This is because they all had easier names. She was poor and always seen wearing a faded blue dress. Her classmates teased her because she claimed to have 100 dresses all lined up in her closet, albeit always been seen wearing one. Her classmates teased her because she claimed to have 100 dresses all lined up in her closet, albeit always been seen wearing one. The ones who mainly teased her were the two best friends, Peggy and Maddie. The one who mainly teased her were the two best friends, Peggy and Maddie. Peggy was the most famous girl in school, while anyone barely knew Wanda. Peggy and Maddie used to wait for Wanda before school even if it meant getting late. Maddie, a poor girl herself, did not like when Peggy made fun of Wanda. She feared that she could be next. She wanted Peggy to stop making fun of Wanda, but could not summon courage to face her, as she feared she lose her best friend. However, Peggy's intention was never to hurt Wanda, but she was curious as to why Wanda had to lie that she had 100 dresses in her closet. Peggy's intention was never to hurt Wanda, but she was curious as to why Wanda had to lie that she had 100 dresses in her closet. Truth about the same 100 dresses unveiled on the result day of the drawing competition. The room was lined with 100 drawings portraying different dresses, each so beautiful. That day, she truly had 100 dresses all lined up, but in the classroom. At that moment, Peggy and Maddie, who were awestruck, realized the theory of a 100 races and felt guilty about having treated her badly. Now go for the details of the chapter. This story revolves around a girl named Wanda Petronsky and her classmates Peggy and Madeline, who made fun of her. The plot of the story opens upon Monday. Even Peggy and Madeline did not notice that Wanda was not present. There were the girls who began all the teasing. Wanda generally used to sit in the corner of the classroom where the not so academically brilliant and loud guys sat. It was that part of the classroom which was the dirtiest, but Wanda was not like those boys. She was silent to the extent that nobody had ever seen her laugh. Nobody knew exactly why Wanda sat in that seat. Nobody knew exactly why Wanda sat in that seat, unless it was because she came all the way from Boggins Heights and her feet were usually caked with dry mud. But no one really thought much about Wanda Petronsky once she sat in the corner of the room. The time when they thought about Wanda was outside of school hours. At noon time when they were coming back to school or in the morning early before school began, when groups of two or three or even more would be talking and laughing on their way to schoolyard. Then sometimes they waited for Wanda to have fun with her. Since Wanda was nothing like those boys, no one ever understood why she sat there. There were only guesses that it is because she came from Boggins Heights and her shoes were usually dirty with all the mud. People hardly noticed her in the classroom as she was silent and alone all the time. It was only before or after school hours when groups of kids used to wait for her to mock her that they thought of her. Some used to wait even at the cost of getting late for school. The next day, Tuesday, Wanda was not in school either, and nobody noticed her absence again. But on the Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, who sat down front with other children, who got good marks, and who did not track in a whole lot of mud, did notice that Wanda wasn't there. Peggy was the most popular girl in school. She was pretty, she had many pretty clothes, and her hair was curly. Maddie was her closest friend. The reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Wanda's absence was because Wanda had made them late to school. They had waited and waited for Wanda to have some fun with her, and she just hadn't come. They often waited for Wanda Petronsky to have fun with her. The fact that Wanda was not present on Tuesday as well got unnoticed, but it was on Wednesday when Maddie and Peggy noticed her absence. It was also then when they waited before school to make fun of her, but instead ended up getting late because she did not show up. Peggy was the most famous girl who wore good and tidy clothes. She sat with the toppers of the class. No one ever got curious about why Wanda was no longer coming to school. All they cared was they couldn't make fun of her. Wanda was a Pole, that is a Polish girl, who had immigrated to America. हर फेलो क्लासमेट थॉट दैट वांडा पेट्रोंस्की वॉज ए स्ट्रेंज नेम बिकॉज दे हैड सिंपल एंड ईजियर अमेरिकन नेम्स सिंपलर एंड ईजियर अमेरिकन नेम्स एक्सेप्ट ए गाय नेम्ड विली बॉन्स विच दे थॉट साउंडेड फनी बट स्टिल लेसर दैन पेट्रोंस्की. दे फाउंड हर नेम टू बी लॉन्ग एंड अनफैमिलियर. This shows that those children did not understand diversity and whatever they did was done out of thoughtlessness. Wanda was usually seen wearing a faded blue dress that did not fit her properly. Though clean, it used to look unironed. This shows that Wanda belonged to a poor family who could not afford too much dresses or too many dresses. Ironically, a lot of people talked to her, but she didn't have any friends because all of them talked to her in order to make fun of her. From her tale about 100 dresses to her unfamiliar name. From her tale about 100 dresses to her unfamiliar name, they found it all amusing. When she used to watch little girls play in the ground, it was at that time other students surrounded her to mock her, that is, make fun of her. With no intentions of hurting her, Peggy used to ask the number of dresses. Wanda has, in a very polite and respectful tone, they made fun of her because they could not understand why she made up that story about 100 dresses. With no intentions of hurting her, Peggy used to ask the number of dresses Wanda has, in a very polite and respectful tone. They made fun of her because they couldn't understand why she made up that story about 100 dresses. They did all this while being ignorant of the fact that it could hurt her. No one would believe her when she said to be possessed of 100 dresses, all lined up in her closet. As the other girls screamed in astonishment, the little girls would stop playing in order to see what was going on. Wanda would affirm these queries that she had dresses made of velvet and silk too. Sadly, after she left, they all used to laugh at her. All alike. Oh, no. Every pair is different. All colors, all lined up. Peggy, who had thought of this game, and Maddie, her inseparable friend, were always the last to leave. Finally, Wanda would move up to the street and her eyes dull and her mouth closed. Hitching her left shoulder every now and then in a funny way, she had finishing the walk to school alone. It was hard to believe what Wanda said because the only dress she was seen wearing was the blue one that was faded. No one was sure as to why she lied. Although they were teasing her, they were never rude to her. Thus, in the same tone, they continued asking her about the number of shoes she said she had, to which she replied 60. Each pair different. It was Peggy's idea to embarrass her like that. Though she was polite, Peggy and Maddie, the inseparable friends, were the last ones to leave school, while Wanda would go back all alone with her dull eyes and behaved in a strange way. Peggy was not the mean girl she had been portrayed as until now. सी सेप्ट किड्स फ्रॉम हु एवर वॉज हर्टिंग देम एंड कूडंट स्टैंड एनिमल्स गेटिंग बैडली ट्रीटेड अकॉर्डिंग टू हर सी वॉज नॉट बींग रीड टू वॉन्डा सी थॉट इट वॉज वेरी वर्ड ऑफ वॉन्डा टू लाई अबाउट द नंबर ऑफ ट्रेसेस एंड पोजेस्ड एंड इफ एनी थिंग वॉज वर्डर इट वॉज हर नेम वर्डर मीन्स स्ट्रेंज ओवर ईयर इट वॉज हर नेम that they found a strange or word or very peculiar. No matter how much they teased Wanda, they never made her cry. Maddie did not like the idea of making fun of the number of clothes and accessories Wanda possessed, not because she cared about her, but because she was poor herself. She wore clothes that were given to her by someone else, but she was not as poor as Wanda. She did not live in Boggins Heights and did not even have a ward name. Maddie didn't feel very comfortable teasing Wanda, and when Peggy used to ask Wanda those questions, she would silently count the marbles in her hands, pretending to play with them. If that race game hadn't been invented, Maddie would have never known about the very existence of Wanda. She felt uncomfortable not because she cared about Wanda, but because she was worried she could be next. Although she was not senseless enough to say she had 100 races, she still wished that Peggy did not tease Wanda. Wanda didn't come that day, and after having waited for her so long, Maddie and Peggy got late for school. Maddie was secretly happy that they could not get a chance to make fun of Wanda. She was lost in her own thoughts and couldn't study properly. All this time, she kept thinking about writing a note to Peggy telling her to stop making fun of Wanda, which she did write. After finishing arithmetic, she wanted to write a note because she knew she did not have the guts to say it on her face. While writing the note to Peggy, Maddie shook at the imagination of her being a new target for Peggy and the girls. She was afraid that they would ask where she got that dresses from, which was actually Peggy's, Maddie's mother. She was afraid that they would ask where she got that dresses from, which was actually Peggy's. Maddie's mother got it transformed with new legs. Maddie's mother got it transformed with new lasses and ribbons so that none of her classmates could identify it. While writing the note to Peggy, Maddie shook at the imagination of her being a new target for Peggy and the girls. She was afraid that they would ask where she got that dresses from, which was actually Peggy's, that is, belonged to Peggy. Maddie's mother got it transformed with new lasses and ribbons so that none of her classmates could identify it. She wished Peggy stopped having fun with Wanda on her own. Suddenly, she ran her hand through her hair. Suddenly, she ran her hand through her hair as a gesture to drive away all those thoughts. She said to herself, Peggy is the most liked girl in the room. She said to herself, Peggy is the most liked girl in the room, her best friend, and so she couldn't be wrong. Thus, she tore and threw that note away. She was also afraid of losing her friend Peggy. After Maddie had cleared her thoughts about confessing to Peggy, she started thinking about Wanda. She thought that Wanda was just another girl living in Boggins Heights who hardly spoke to anybody. She remembers when Wanda talked about her pale blue dress. She remembers when Wanda talked about her pale blue dress and jungle green dress paired with the red sash. The girl made fun of her by saying that she would rather look like a Christmas tree in that dress. While thinking about Wanda, Maddie began thinking about the drawing contest in which the boys had to design motorboats and girls had to design dresses. Peggy was the obvious winner of that competition because she was the best artist in the room. She could copy exact pictures and recognizable portraits. She was sure that Peggy would win, and the result was to be announced the next day when everyone would know what's what. The day when the results were to be announced, it was raining lightly, and thus the two best friends ran quickly to school without waiting for Wanda. Generally, they used to wait for her at the Oliver Street that led to Boggins Heights, the place where Wanda lived, but they didn't wait that day. Even if it wasn't raining that day, they wouldn't have waited for her because the day was crucial as the results were to be announced. When the best friends entered the classroom, Peggy asked Maddie if Miss Mason would announce the results or not, to which Maddie said yes. Maddie told that she believed Peggy would win, but to their utter surprise, when they entered the class, there were drawings all over the room. Bright and brilliant, they left everyone in awe. There were drawings all over the room, bright and brilliant, they left everyone in awe. That is a surprise. They were the drawings for the contest. Miss Mason announced the winners after everyone had seated or settled. Among the boys, Jack Bagels had on. He drew an outdoor motor which was displayed in room number 12 along with drawings made of other boys. She then talked about girls' submissions. She mentioned that there was one such girl who had submitted 100 designs. It's so beautiful that the judges felt that any out of them was worthy of the gold medal. Miss Mason very proudly announced Wanda as the winner of the competition. She continued and sadly mentioned that Wanda had not been coming since days, hoping she would be there the next day. She instructed everyone to look at the flawless collections टू विच एवरी वन अप्लॉडेड एंड विस एंड विसल्ड मैडी एंड पेगी इवन सॉ द ब्लू ड्रेस दैट वांडा हैड टॉक्ड अबाउट इट वॉज ब्यूटिफुल पेगी साइड आई थॉट आई कुड ड्रॉ विच मीन्स दैट द ड्राइंग्स लेफ्ट हर इन इमेंस एडमिरेशन Miss Mason continued and sadly mentioned that Wanda had not been coming since days, hoping she would be there the next day. She instructed everyone to look at the flawless collections too, which everyone applauded and whistled. Maddie and Peggy even saw the blue dresses that Wanda had talked about. It was beautiful. Peggy sighed. I thought I could draw, which means that the drawings left her in immense admiration.